how to write an algorithm, right? So we will take one more example so that you can understand. So the example is write an algorithm. Write an algorithm and flowchart to find average of three numbers. Can you please tell me how to find the average of the three numbers? Or what is an average? Yes. So firstly, we have to write an algorithm to find out the average of three numbers. Means suppose they have given to you a three numbers, N1, N2, and N3. So to find the average of these three numbers, firstly, you have to add all these three numbers. So N1 plus N2 plus N3. And suppose this addition is stored in variable sum. You can take any variable name. So here I am taking the sum variable. So addition of these three numbers are stored in some variable. Suppose we need to find out the next one is the average. So how to find out the average? So the sum of all the three numbers divided by total numbers. So how many such a total numbers are there? 1, 2, and 3. So total three numbers are there. So to find out the average of three numbers, we have to calculate firstly the sum of the three numbers and they divided by total numbers. So total numbers are three. So sum divided by three. So in this formula, we can calculate the average of three numbers. Okay. Now, firstly, we will write the algorithm. So how to write the algorithm? First of all, so first step is start. Then second step is we need to read the three numbers from user. So here I am reading the three numbers N1, N2 and N3. Okay. Next one is third step is you have to calculate the sum of all these three numbers. So here I am taking sum is equal to N1 plus N2 plus N3. And the last one, fourth one is we have to calculate the average. So for that, I'm taking the AVG as a variable name. So which is equal to sum divided by total numbers is 3. So in this way, you can calculate the average. And at the last step, we have to display or print the average on the screen. So print average, AVG variable. Okay. And the last step is stop. So as you can see, algorithm which contain finite number of steps. So total 6 number of step, which is a finite. Finite means there is a end of for the steps. So first step is start. Next, we read the three numbers. Then after that, we add all these three numbers and that addition is get stored into the sum variable. After that, I'm taking one AVG variable, that is the average variable, which is equal to, I'm dividing this sum by 3, then it will, that division is stored into the AVG variable. And after that, I'm just printing the AVG variable, means the value of AVG variable and the stop. So this is an algorithm. Now, next one is we have to draw the flowchart for the given algorithm. So flowchart is firstly start. There is a symbol for the start and the stop, right? So here I'm drawing this symbol for start and stop. So this is a symbol is used for start step and the stop step. So start. Next one is read N1, N2, N3. So we are taking input from the user. So for this reason, we have to use an input symbol. So input symbol for input and output symbol, we use a parallelogram. So here I'm writing read N1, N2, N3. So read N1, N2, and N3. Next one is sum. Here I'm going to calculate or processing is done or calculations is done. So for that reason, we use a processing symbol. So for processing or for calculations, we use a rectangle. Okay, here I'm going to calculate sum using N1 plus N2 plus N3. Now the next one is average. Again, I'm using a processing symbol or the calculating symbol for calculations of average. Again, I can use a rectangle. Either you can include the average in this same rectangle or you can use the second rectangle also. It depends on your choice. You can use one more rectangle or you can include the step in first rectangle itself. Suppose I'm taking the another rectangle for calculating the average. Have to calculate the average sum divided by the numbers. So total numbers are 3. So here I'm using a processing symbol. Next one is I need to print the average, means I'm going to print output on the screen. So for this printing, I'm using an output symbol. So this is again input and output symbol. So again, we use a parallelogram for output. So here I'm going to print AVG. And the last step is stop. So for stop, again, we use the same symbol, which is used for the start. So here is stop. And we know that our flow of the program, which is starts from the start symbol to the stop. So these are the flow lines. Okay, so in this way, you can draw the flow chart as well as algorithm for any problem or any program, right? So in this way, you can write algorithm as well as flow chart. So this is the most important thing, because before writing any program, you should know how to write an algorithm, how to draw the flowchart, and after that you can implement this algorithm and flowchart into the program. Okay, so first of all, this two is very important, algorithm and the flowchart. Completed writing. Okay. Similarly, we can solve as many problems for algorithm and flowchart, but I think it's too easy. So we will move on the C programs or the C language. Fine. Now we will start the C program or the C language. So next one is overview of C language. Next topic. Overview of C language means how the C is developed. So before C, is there any languages? Is there any other languages which was evolved? So we will see overview. Okay. Overview of C language. So what is the overview of C language? So before C language evolved, some other languages are introduced or developed before C language. The first language which was developed before the C language, that is Algol language. And this Algol language is the first structure computer language which is developed in 1960s. Okay, so before C, there is a one language which is evolved or which is introduced and whose name is Algol. Algol, which is the first structured language developed in 1960s. Okay, the next language which is evolved after the Algol is BCPL. BCPL means what? Basic Combined Programming Language, which is again developed in 1967 and developed by Martin Richards. So next second language is BCPL. The full form for BCPL is Basic Combined Programming Language, which is developed by Martin Richard. In 1967. Okay, so these are the histories of the C language. The next evolution is B language. B means basic. Okay, so B language, which is based on BCPL and developed by Ken Thompson in 1917. Okay, which is the basic language. Or we can say it is a basic C language. So next language is B, means basic, based on BCPL. BCPL developed by Ken Thompson in 1970s. So these languages are developed in 1917. Next one is, after this B language, the C language was developed in 1972 by Dennis Ritchie in Bell Laboratories in USA. Okay, so in USA, there is one Bell Laboratory in which C language was developed by Dennis Ritchie in 1972. So in 1972, the C language was evolved or developed by Dennis Ritchie in 1972. In USA Bell Laboratory. So these are some overviews of the C language. So it is a strictly speaking a middle level language which has the feature of both high level language as well as low level language. So C language is called as the middle level language because it contains both the features of high level language as well as low level language features. So that's why it is said to be a middle level language. Fine. So next is C is called as middle level language. C is middle level language because it support both high level language and low level language. So it supports both high level language, or it includes the feature of high level language as well as the low level language feature. That's why C is said to be a middle level language. Okay, then so the next one is for developing the C language, we need one software, or we need one software to implement the program for C language. So there are various softwares available in the market, and that software is said to be a IDE. IDE means what? Integrated Development Environment. So in C language, or for C language, we use Turbo C or Turbo C++ IDE for developing or editing a C program. Okay, so there are various softwares available in market. You can use anything. You can use Visual Studio also. You can use Turbo C also. You can use ANSI C also. You can use Borderland C also. It depends on, there are various softwares available in the market. But now we are use a Turbo C IDE for developing a C program and editing a C program. Okay. So the next one is structure of C program. Next topic is, are you getting what is the overview? It is just a introduction session. Then next one is structure of C program. What is the structure of the C program? We will see in this case. So any C program basically consists of some features. Okay, so it consists of collection of one or more function. Then every function name is followed by the pair of parentheses, means rounded bracket open, rounded bracket close. So every function name is followed by the pair of parentheses, and our program contains one or more functions. Then it consists of at least one mandatory or compulsory function, and that compulsory function name is main function. Okay, so content or statement within a functions are written within a pair of braces. Always remember, the rounded brackets are set to be a parenthesis, and curly braces are said to be a braces. Okay, so every statements or the every contents within the functions are enclosed in pair of curly braces. Okay, next is execution. This is the important point. Execution always starts from the main function. Main is the origin of our program. So execution always starts from the main function. Then every function returns a value, otherwise we use a void, void, void or nothing. Void, the meaning of void means what? Nothing. Okay, so every function returns a value. It depend, we will see after that what are the return type of the functions. So, but if the function does not return anything, then you can use a void symbol. The meaning of void means what? Nothing. Okay. So usually every program contains hash at the top. Hash is the preprocessor directive. So hash, the statement which starts from the hash symbol, that is said to be a preprocessor directives. So which contains either files or the definition. And always remember, C language is the case sensitive language, means the uppercase and the lowercase characters are different. Suppose I can use add, capital add as a function name, then this is a different function name. And if I'm using a small add, then this is it's considered as these two are the different functions. Fine, because the C language is case sensitive, means uppercase and lowercase characters are different in C language. So that's why it is a case sensitive language. Then after that, every statement end with the semicolon in C language. So every statement which is terminated with the semicolon. Semicolon means what? Dot and comma. So this is said to be a semicolon. So every statement in C language enclosed, every statement in C language enclosed with the or end with the semicolon, it is said to be a terminator, line terminator or the statement terminator. So dot and the comma. This is said to be a semicolon. So every statement end with the semicolon. Then we can use a comment. Comment means these comments are used for documentation purpose. Documentation means what? Suppose we want to tell other user, or we want to write some information about the code or about the statement, then we use a comment for that reason. And this comment is used for the documentation purpose. Suppose I want to send or I want to write some information about the code which is ignored by the system, then such a type of statement or such a type of instruction information is said to be a comment. So in C language there are two comments. First one is a multi-line comment, and the second one is single line comment. Multi-line comment and single line comment. Multi-line comment is always starts with forward slash star and it is end with the star slash. Multi-line means if we want to write the information or documentation about the code which contains multiple lines, then that documentation or that information is enclosed in multi-line comment so that it is ignored by the compiler or the system. हा जो काही कोड असेल या कमेंटमधला तो कंपायलरकडनं इग्नोर होईल, तो त्याला एक्झिक्यूट करणार नाही. सो इट इज जस्ट फॉर द इन्फॉर्मेशन पर्पज. कमेंट, वी कॅन यूज कमेंट फॉर द इन्फॉर्मेशन पर्पज. सिमिलरली सिंगल लाईन कमेंट इज ऑलवेज स्टार्ट्स विथ डबल स्लॅश अँड इट एंड विथ द लाईन. ओके, अँड दिस कमेंट इज यूज्ड ओनली फॉर द सिंगल लाईन. Okay, if you want to write down the multiple lines, or if you want to write the information in which is in multiple lines, then you have to use a multi-line comment which starts from slash star and end with the star slash. Are you getting? So this is the multi-line comment. Now we will see, these are some information we should know. So first information is C language contains the one or more functions. And the most important function is main, because the execution of the program is always starts with main function. So what is the structure of the program, C program? Firstly, we have to define preprocessor directives. Preprocessor directives. This is the first structure, or definition, or preprocessor definitions. This is the first structure or first line. Next one is void main function. Void main function. And the next structure is user defined function. Okay, so in this way there is a structure for C program. Firstly, you have to define the preprocessor directives or the definition of macros, such things. Then second step should be our void main, and next one is user defined function. For example, here I am writing the example so that you can understand. Preprocessor directives is always starts with hash symbol. Here I can include the files or header files, or you can include the definition of the function. Next one is void main. In void main, we can write statements or the sequence of statements. So in this case, we write the main function. So main function contains the multiple statement. Here is variable declaration, definition, some calculations, processing steps. After that, after void main, we can define the user defined function. It is optional depending on the program. So how to define a user defined function, we will see this afterward. But for example, I'm just considering. So this is the user defined function. So in this way, we can write a C program like this. Firstly, we have to include the header files or some definition of the constant or anything. Then after that, our session is void main, and after that the user defined function. Okay, so this is the normal structure of C program. Are you getting? As we can see, this is the main function, and every function is followed by the parenthesis. Parenthesis means what? Opening rounded bracket and closing rounded bracket. So this is main is also function, add is also function, because add again followed by the parenthesis. And we can see the return type of this main is the void, because it does not return anything. We will see afterwards. There are various data types provided by the C language, so we can use this data type as a return type of the function. So if our function does not return anything, then we can specify the void as a return type. Similarly, here add also has a return type, which is a void. Void means what? Nothing. Means that function does not return anything. Okay, so this is the normal structure of the C program. stdio.h is the header file of the program. Header file .h extension means what? Header file. So stdio.h means what? Standard input output file. So the file which are stored in a library and which contains the definition of all the functions, and that functions are used for input and output purpose. Okay, those function which are used for input and output purpose, so that functions definitions is written in the stdio.h header file, and these all header files are stored in a C libraries. So there are various header files. So in C language we use stdio.h. there are various header file. If we are using a mathematical function, like taking the square root, for taking the maximum number, minimum number, for that reason we use a math.h header file. Okay, so there are various header files are included in C libraries. So math.h is again one kind of header file. Then we have a conio.h header file. We will see afterward why to use conio.h, how to use a math.h. Then there are various header files provided or written in header in C libraries. Okay, now stdio.h means what? Standard input output. Fine. So this is the normal structure of the C program. Are you getting? Comments and structure of the C program. Next one is the character sets. Next one is the character sets which are used in C language. Character sets. Okay. So, what is a character set? It refers to a characters that are recognized and accepted in C language. So, which characters and which sets are accepted in C language, that includes in character sets. Okay. Those characters, those symbols, and those digits or some special characters are included in this character set. So, which are accepted in C language? The first character set is all alphabets from capital A to Z and from small a to Z are accepted in C language. So, the character set which includes capital A to capital Z and small a to small Z are accepted in C language. Okay. So this is the first character set. Second one is the digit from 0 to 9 is again accepted in C program or C character set. Again, there is some special symbol which are accepted in C language or C programming language. And they are, that special characters or that special symbols are hash, star, forward slash, double and, double or, then less than, greater than, rounded parenthesis, curly braces, semicolon, comma. These all are the special symbols which are used in C languages. So which are they? First is hash symbol. Then next one is less than, greater than, then rounded brackets, then curly brackets, comma operator, then semicolon, then after that double or, then after that star, okay, etc. There are various symbols which are used in C language. These are the basic symbols. Okay. Then next one is some special characters are also used in C language. And these special characters are blank spaces and the tab spaces. Space characters are also used in character set, and that are the blank space and the tab space. So blank space and tab space. Blank space and tab space. Fine. Then after that, some backslash characters are also used. Backslash character or escape sequences. Okay. Backslash character is also said to be a escape sequences. These are also used in C character set. It is also said to be a escape sequences. Escape sequence. And backslash character is always starts with backslash. There are various backslash characters, slash n, slash a, slash t, slash h, then slash r, then double slash, slash question mark, then slash star, etc. There are various backslash characters or escape sequences which is used in C program, and that backslash character or escape sequences are included in a C character set. So these are the C character sets which we are using in our program, C program. Okay. The next topic is tokens. Next, we will discuss the next topic, that is the token. So first of all, what is the token means? Token is the smallest unit of the program, which is the smallest unit within a program. The program. The smallest unit within the program is said to be a token. Okay, so there are various tokens which are used in C program. Means we can use various smallest units within our program, and we will discuss now this smallest unit. So the first smallest unit or first token is keyword. Second token is identifier. Then third token is constant. Okay. Then next token is literals. Fourth one is literals. Okay, so these are the smallest thing which are used in our C program, and these are the smallest things are said to be as an token. So now we will discuss one by one, what is a keyword, what is an identifier, what is the constant, what is the literals. Okay, we will study one by one. Firstly, we will study the keyword. First one is keyword. So what is a keyword? So keywords are the reserve words. So these keywords are the reserve words, means whose meaning is already defined in the C libraries. Okay, so the keywords are which are reserve words whose meaning is already defined in the libraries. So we can only use that keywords. Okay, so there are various keywords which are used in C. So keywords means what? They are predefined meaning words. These words have already been specifically defined with the meaning which cannot be changed. We cannot change its meaning. Okay. And which are already defined. So all the keywords are in lowercase. We can use all the keywords in lowercase symbol. Such as there are various keywords which are used in C language. There are basically 32 keywords in ANSI C language. Okay. And there few more have been also added later. So total 32 keywords are there which are used in C language. So I'm going to write that keywords, and all the keywords are in lowercase. For example, void is keyword. Int is keyword, float is keyword, char is keyword, include is keyword, then const is keyword, define is keyword, Then we have long keyword. We have short keyword. Then double is also keyword. There are various such keywords are included in C language, and few more are also added in further version. Okay, so in this way, keywords means what? Whose meaning is already defined by the compiler. We can only use that keyword. We cannot change its meaning. Okay, so each and every keyword has particular meaning, and which is already defined by the compiler. So we can only use that keyword. So we will see afterward how to use each and every keyword and what are the meaning of each and every keywords. Okay, just only remember keywords, and we cannot use these keywords as to define the variable name, to define the function, or to define the constant, okay, or to define the structure name. Means these keywords are not used as an variable name, as a function name, as a structure name, or as a constant name. We cannot define this keyword as a variable, function, structure, and the constant. Fine. So they are only used as a keyword only. Next one is an identifier. Second token is identifier. So identifier means what? Identifiers are the names given to a variable, function, constant. Okay, always remember. So what is the identifier? Identifiers are the name which is given to a function. We can give a name to the function, then that name is said to be an identifier. Then we can give a name for variable also, then that variable name is also said to be an identifier. We can give a name to the constant also, then that constant name is also an identifier. We can give the name to the structure also, then that structure name is also an identifier. We can give a name to the union also, then that name of the union is also an identifier. Okay, so the name which is given to a variable, the name which is given to a function, the name which is given to a constant, structure, and union are said to be an identifier. So there are some rules to define an identifier. So we need to know that rules to define an identifier. Okay, so first rule to define an identifier is identifier always start or begin with a letter. Okay, it always starts with letter and end with the letter also. Start with letter. So there are various letter, uppercase letters and lowercase letters, means the letters which include the alphabets from capital A to Z and small a to Z. So it always, identifier always starts with the letter, not a digit. If my identifier is like this, 8 ABC, then it is not an valid identifier. It is not valid. Suppose my identifier is starts with add A. You can see here add is starts with the letter alphabets, so it is again a valid identifier. Okay, but suppose my identifier is starts with dollar symbol, dollar add, then it is again invalid identifier because it starts with special symbol dollar. So it is again invalid identifier. So always remember, your identifier must starts with the letter. This is the first rule. Second rule is the symbol underscore is treated as a letter. We can use underscore character as a letter also. Okay, this is the underscore character. Underscore is also treated as a character in C identifier. So you can start the identifier with underscore character also. Suppose I'm defining identifier or a variable name like this, underscore add, then it is a valid character. Or here I'm defining student name, then for in this identifier, I'm using underscore character, student name. So again, this is a valid identifier. Okay, means you can use underscore in to define identifier also, because it is treated as the letter. So underscore character is also permitted, also allowed to define an identifier. Then third rule is it cannot contain blank space in between. We cannot define identifier which contains a blank space. Suppose I am defining variable name as S name or student name, then it is not allowed because it contains a space over here. So this is not a valid identifier. So blank space is not allowed to define a function name, to define a variable name, to define a constant name, structure and union. So we cannot give a blank space. Either you can include a underscore character, or this identifier must not contain a space. It depends on you. So third rule is blank space not allowed. Okay, this is the third rule. Then fourth rule is we cannot use keywords as an identifier. It means we cannot use a keyword for defining a function name. Suppose I'm using function name as a include. Your function name include is not valid because include is the keyword, and you cannot define the variable name, function name or structure name as a include because include is a keyword. You cannot define the identifier such as struct. Struct is also one kind of keyword. Struct is also keyword. You cannot define this struct as an identifier. So keywords are not used as an identifier. We cannot use keywords as an identifier. Okay. The next rule is fifth rule is should our identifier should be less than 32 character, which increases the portability in ANSI C. Our identifier should be less than 32 characters. Okay. Should be less than 32 characters. So these are the rules we should know to define an identifier. Okay. Identifier always starts with the letter, means we cannot start identifier with numbers or some special symbols. We always starts with the letter or underscore character. Okay, then next rule is blank spaces are not allowed. If I want to define an identifier which contains some blank space, then it is again not allowed identifier. Then next one is keyword. We are not using a keyword to define an identifier. Suppose I want to give a function name, variable name or anything as a keyword, then it is not allowed because keyword already defined means who has their own meaning and which is already defined. So we cannot use that keywords as an identifier. And our identifier should be less than 32 characters. So these are the rules you should know. Are you getting? So the next token is constant. Third token, constant. Constant, the meaning of constant means fixed. Okay, so fixed means what? Constant means the variable which are or which has a fixed value, so we cannot change its value. Then such a type of variables are said to be a constant. So it is referred to a fixed value. That means we do not change that their value during the program execution. Such a values are said to be a constant. So there are various constant. Constant means what? Fixed value. We cannot change its value during program execution. So there are various constant. Character constant, which contain suppose A, then small capital T, K. These are the character constants. You can take any alphabets, okay? So these are the character constants whose value cannot be changed. If I'm giving any variable as a value A, as a T or as a K or any alphabet, then we cannot change its value during program execution. Okay. So these are the fixed value. So first is character constant, then we can have integer constant also. Integer constant also means numbers. Any numbers, 87, 54, any numbers, 12, 9, 0. These are the values we cannot change during program execution. If I'm giving this value to the variable, then I cannot change its value during program execution. So these are again a constant. We have a string constant also. String constant also means the sequence of character which are included in double quotes are said to be a string. String kashala mentat, sequence of characters, characters chi sequences asil means number of characters which are enclosed in double quotes. Then that string is, that sequence is said to be a string. And single character is always enclosed in single quotes. You can see over here, I'm enclosing a single character in single quote and I'm enclosing sequence of characters in double quotes. So this sequence of characters are said to be a string. You can take any string. Suppose my string is India, then you can enclose in double quotes. So these are the string constant. Similarly, you can have a float constant also, floating point constant. Floating point constant means what? The number which contains a decimal point. Suppose 3.14 is my constant value. 8.5 is again 8.6, 8.5, anything which contains a decimal point value, then that constant is said to be a floating point constant. And these are also said to be a literals. Capital A, T, K, these constants are said to be a literals also. Okay. So are you getting what is a constant? Constant, which is referred to as a fixed value. We cannot change its value during the program execution. So there are various constant, character constant, integer constant, string constant, floating point constant, any constant. if I'm defining or if I'm giving any variable name, any variable value as a constant, then I cannot change that constant value during the program execution because it is a fixed value. So this is all about the constant.